Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see the difference between ETL and ELT. So ETL is being there for long, like over 2 to 3 decades, and ELT is also there, but it is always a little confusing, and it becomes a recent history after invention of cloud and big data technologies. This has got so famous. Let us try to narrow down the difference between these two. Let us check in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in data warehouse. Let us start with the ETL. It stands for extract, transform, and load, and we have seen what are different types of ETL tools available in the market, and we have seen in our previous video how it will help in data warehouse, what role it plays. So again, quick explanation about that. Like, when we extract from different sources, putting in a staging area, and you bring whatever required to be part in your data warehouse, and you will transform and load. So the cycle follows as extraction of whichever is important and transforming a data and loading it. The ultimate aim of ETL is like extract, transform and load, and your source and target, right? So this is your target. So before loading into a target, you do extraction, transform and load. So this process happening in before you loading into a target. So people confuse with like, I am extracting here and immediately I am loading. So I am doing ELT in the data warehouse itself. So this is the confusion people always will have. So assuming like source and target, what operations you do in between, that matters. So you are extraction and transforming and loading to your target, right? That is why it is called ETL. And also note that whatever required informations you bring here, right, those things are well designed. So only you bring the important data, and whatever required for your analytics, those things only you will bring. So this is quite straightforward. And what about ELT? So you transform this first, like, I mean, it's exchange of word. Instead of you do the extract, transform and load, you extract, load and then transform. What it means? So all it comes to your ELT process when it comes to a big data and cloud technologies, where you bring all data, whatever irrespective of whether it's useful or not, just bring and load it into your big data processing or Hadoop file system, like data lakes, right, where you just extract it and load your data. Then whenever it is required for your analysis, you transform it, right? So your ultimate aim is to this is your target, and what you are doing, you are loading it first without any transformations, and then you are transforming at the report layer only. I mean, when it comes, whenever you, based on the different report requirement, you get the data and transform it and report it directly. So this is what your ELT stands for. And you just try to figure it out. Like ETL, the data warehouse design is very clear, and it is dimension modeling, different facts, different dimension. You did all your ETL process, and whenever it is required, minor kind of transformation can be done in your analytics or reporting side. This is your ETL. Whereas ELT, just load your data, whatever it is, that dump data, you dump your data in your the data lake or your Azure data lakes, like distributed file systems or Hadoop systems, where you place your data, load it first, then transform it. So this is the exchangeably used. And in case of process, whether the tools will change, I hope no. The tools remains same. And in case of big data, that might be some more inclusive here, but the tools does the same purpose. Whether you do the ETL or ELT, it is same. Just loading it and then transforming it, or you are transform it or loading it. So this is what the confusion you should avoid. So ETL, straightforward. When you have a conventional data warehouse, you are doing ETL. And in case of big data processing and your cloud systems process, you are going for ELT. So this is what the two typical architecture. So in case of data warehouse, you are following the ETL process. In case of your conventional big data processing, you are doing ELT. So you can compare it over here. I hope I tried to explain as much simpler terms, and I hope you understand the difference now. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.